All right, so you know why we're here. We're here to welcome the pioneer of role-playing games and the creator of Final Fantasy. So let's just get to it and welcome out Hironobu Sakaguchi.
Maybe I'm the guy.
And translating for Sakaguchi-san is the lovely Kyoko Higo. This is a fantastic turnout. Look at this. We were worried if this is going to fill up, but look at all of you, the bunch of you. This is fantastic. So thank you for joining us today. We're going to talk a little bit about the past, present, and future of role-playing games as viewed through the eyes of Hironobu Sakaguchi. So let's jump into it. All right, so now we're going to flip the script.
Okay.
Fast forward to the kind of semi-present. With Blue Dragon, you sort of got the Chrono Trigger band back together. You got Uematsu-san, you got Toriyama-san together. In hindsight, how do you feel about how Blue Dragon turned out? Was there ever a long-term plan for Blue Dragon? You know, is that something you'd ever go back to?
ブルードラゴンは鳥山明先生とかと一緒に仕事されて、やっぱり僕は中学高校の頃鳥山明の漫画で育ったんで、もう何しろ大ファンだし、その鳥山さんの絵でゲームが作りたいっていうのはもちろんクロノトリガーで、そういう夢が叶って、ブルードラゴンもそれの2回目ですよね。で、今日はちょっと写真を、その時の開発チームに鳥山さんが来てくれた時があって、ちょっと特別に持ってきました。
Yeah, so I grew up on, you know, creations by Toriyama Akira Sensei. You know, junior high and high school. It was a dream for me to be able to work either with or, you know, get even close to Toriyama-san. So with obviously Chrono Trigger, we were able to make that happen. And with Blue Dragon, it was kind of like the second time we got to work together. And it was a great opportunity, a huge honor and a privilege to work with him. He actually came and visited our studios and checked in from time to time. So I actually brought a photo today, probably has never been shown.
So the man in the red shirt in front with Sakaguchi-san. I don't know where this is.
Yeah, we can't see it.
That's Akira Toriyama, the creator of Dr. Slump and Dragon Ball. This is actually a very rare photo of Toriyama-san. There's not many photos of him in existence.
Yeah.
I hope it's okay that I'm actually showing this today. There may be some issues,
I don't know.
But...
And this is the Blue Dragon team, right?
Yeah, Blue Dragon team.
This is the Blue Dragon team, yes.
So you guys are seeing Toriyama-sensei for the first time, probably, in a photo.
Yeah, very
that's
rare.
That's not 30 years old.
No.
About the Blue Dragon being an ongoing series, was there ever a thought of that?
とりあえずブルードラゴンもその後ロストオデッセイとかラストストーリーとか作ってますけど、今のところやっぱり続編はなくて、新しいものを作っていきたいと思ってるんですけど、ただ逆に水面下ではなんかそんな話も時々出たりして、まだどうなるかわからないですよね、そういうのがね。
Yeah, so currently, you know, there's no official or nothing that's being talked about, obviously, behind closed doors or, you know, just between some of us who worked on it. We would hope or we talk about it once in a while that we'd like to. But not just with Blue Dragon, but also following that with Lost Odyssey and Last Story. all those IPs, there isn't a continuation or a series or, you know, nothing's confirmed. But again, it would be nice to be able to work on a continuation of my old creations.
ブルードラゴン、これそうだ。最初のシナリオ、鳥山さんに没されたんですよね。だから次作るのはちょっと辛いかもしれない。また鳥山さんに没にされちゃって。
So with Blue Dragon though, my first draft of the story, was not accepted by 鳥山先生. He did not accept it. And so, I don't know, even if there were a second attempt, it might be pretty challenging to get through to him.
Speaking of Toriyama-san, what is he like to work with? And the reason I ask is because one time I asked Uematsu-san the same question, and despite the fact that they've worked together on projects, he said that he's never actually been in the same room with Toriyama-san.
Toriyama-san, what同じ作品は担当してるけど一緒になったことが
一緒。上松さん、上松さん、こもって音楽作ってるからね。あんまりチームには入ってこないよね。一人で仕事して。
So with 上松さん、he sort of likes to work by himself.
Yeah.
So he's actually the one that's kind of in his little hole working on his own operation. He doesn't really come out as much, despite the
lonely guy.
Lonely guy.
鳥山さんはもうとにかくやっぱ発想がすごくて、次から次アイデアをいろいろ出してくるのと、ただ面白いのはフォトショップのバージョン1か2を使ってて、それに慣れちゃってるんで、もう最新のフォトショップは使えない。だから鳥山さんのマックに本当一番最初のフォトショップが入ってるんですよ。
So the great part about 鳥山先生is that he always has great ideas, just freshideas popping in his head, so there's so much to consume when you talk to him. Maybe the downside to that is that on his Mac at the office, or the one that he works on, the Photoshop version that's loaded is like one or two.
Yeah.
He doesn't have anything beyond that. So, the tools have to be in either one or version one or two, and new technology doesn't seem to suit him in that sense.